First of all, my advice is this isn't a very trustworthy company, and I think that they really flunked crisis management 101. The three principles of crisis management are be quick, be candid, and be repentant when a crisis occurs, and they were none of these. They were very late, they haven't been very candid, and they haven't been very repentant. They seem to profit from and capitalize on the mistake early on in their thing. So as an investor, as a consumer, I would have very little trust in Equifax. And the CEO's apology, even today, lack the type of candidness, the type of solution-oriented specifics that people needed to trust this company. It was, again, too vague, too little, too late.
Yeah, I mean, it was 6 weeks after they discovered the breach that they made it public. Initially, when Kelly went online to see if she even was one of those affected, she was going to have to sign up to give up her right to sue the company. They've since taken that away. Under pressure from the New York State Attorney General, and then they were going to charge $10 if you wanted to freeze your account, which they normally do. Now that fee is being waived. I mean, these guys couldn't get out of their own way here initially, but is that just symptomatic of a company that finds itself in a huge crisis that it's not used to?
Absolutely, but they should have been prepared for this crisis. They should have recognized this was a high probability that something like this could have occurred. They should have set up policies and practices in place. For example, if something like this occurs, we make it public immediately. That prevents executives from selling their stocks. You don't have to have all the answers right away. You just have a commitment to finding the answers and the solutions. I'm reminded of, you know, when the Navy SEAL 6 captured Osama bin Laden, one of their helicopters crashed. Why did they handle that well? They had practiced with a replica compound before them. That's what companies need to do. They need to anticipate the crisis. They need to practice how they're going to respond and need to set up solutions immediately.
Professor Galinsky, we've also seen Home Depot and Target as some victims of these really bad breaches, but the point's been made that their primary business is not in data protection, which Equifax now is. So in order for them to recover and arguably, from their point of view, try to come out stronger, what could they do at this point? I mean, when I got on the website earlier today, it was much more straightforward in terms of saying, look, this is what happened initially, but here's all the things we're trying to do now. And now they have a lot more data and information on people as a result of all this data entry into the trusted website. So what can they do now if they want to look back on this and say, you know, we're glad that we ultimately handled that the right way?
Well, first of all, you bring up a really important point, which is this crisis is at their core competency, right? So sometimes a crisis hits and it doesn't affect the core of the business or what they're entrusted to do. So they are in a deep, deep hole because the very thing that they do as a business has now been called into question. And we've seen very few businesses recover in this type of situation. The only way they can cover is by going over and above on every possible dimension that we care about. Protection, helping the consumer, preventing this from happening again, becoming a vanguard in preventing this. I am very, very suspicious that they will ever overcome this core competency crisis, but they have to move mountains to do so, and they need to start now.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.